ever wondered what Kanye West or Ellen DeGeneres taste like? Sounds funny. Or is it gross? Glad to see you again. We appreciate the support. Stay tuned to know more about this crazy celebrity meet. How much would you love to set a place at your table for your favorite celebrity? Well, thinking about whether celebrity meets are real or not? Well, there's a lab meat company out there who is just as curious about the forbidden meat as you are. Bite Labs grows meat from celebrity tissue samples and uses it to make artisanal salami. Salami, as you know, is a cured meat sausage that is fermented and air-dried. Salami was traditionally made from pork, but nowadays it can be made from any type of meat or game. Beef, lamb, duck, venison, even horse or donkey. Or a combination of any of the above. Wait, are you shocked or wondering whether or how they do it? Let's get a quick overview on how it's done. Choosing the celebrity. It all starts with selecting your favorite celebrities and performing a quick biopsy to obtain tissue samples. Culture. They grow celebrity meat in their proprietary bioreactors by isolating muscle stem cells. Meat making. They dry, age, and spice the product in the tradition of Italian cured meats to create fine caricature. Winston Churchill predicted in 1931 that all of the world's meat would be grown in laboratories. What, he wondered, was the point of raising a whole chicken for the sake of its wings of breast meat? Today, in vitro meat production is on the verge of becoming a reality, providing highly controllable meat production without the animal cruelty, disposal and environmental impacts associated with industrial farming. However, this process can provide much more than just beef and pork replicas, the company claims. Still confused about what's happening? Let's have a deeper idea about the process.
When you eat this, it's meat, but I guarantee you it's like no meat you've ever seen before. That's because this stuff was grown from cells in a lab.
Clean meat is meat grown by cell culture rather than...
Myosatellite cells are obtained by a biopsy to begin the actual process. These are specialized stem cells found in adult muscle that repair and regrow damaged muscle. Isolating a sample of these cells provides a foundation for growing as much meat as needed. They allow mysosatellite cells to multiply in a growth medium in order to produce meat in volume. The medium acts as a sort of artificial blood supplying nutrients and growth factors to the cells. The stem cells must not only multiply but also develop into actual muscle. But this happens naturally, as this is a primary function of the stem cells in the first place. The embryonic muscle cells are attached over a sugar support to become meat not only in cell type but also in texture and structure. This not only provides the framework for muscle to grow over, but it also creates channels for growth medium to flow through, similar to veins. The growth process has now moved into bioreactors, where directional activation of the muscles causes them to mature and become stronger. These muscle pieces are blended and ground into the desired consistency once fully grown. At this point, they combine various types of meats according to the recipes for each of their commodities. Spices, fats, and oils are mixed in to flavor and thicken the meat blends. The ground meat is now stuffed into casings and seasoned to perfection. Finally, the salamis are dried, aged, and cured in a traditional low-temperature environment before being packaged for distribution. Their process claims high-quality yield, luxury protein in a sustainable manner that eliminates the environmental and ethical concerns associated with traditional livestock management. But the funny part is, who wants to eat celebrity meat and promote awareness about environmental degradation and ethical concerns? Sounds a little gross. Anyway, such an innovation and a business endeavor involving celebrities is designed with some key visions. Let's take a look on that. Eco-friendly. Celebrity meat production demands less than 1% of the land required for conventional farming. Currently, animals are raised on 70% of the world's farmland, nearly 30% of the entire Earth's surface. Meat production is simply unsustainable today. Unless drastic changes are made, the price of meat will eventually spiral out of control. Health. Laboratory meats are not influenced by growth hormones given to farm animals, nor are they exposed to pesticides or other chemicals used in industrial farming. The nutritional content of the products can be strictly regulated. Farms are filthy and animals are susceptible to infection. The lab is a clean environment where they can grow safer and healthier products.
This number rise in the coming decades. According to the World Economic Forum, the world population is expected to be...
Anyways, lab-grown meat has the potential to feed the world's population while combating climate change. Can you stomach the thoughts of steaks or cured meats grown from human cells? The weirdest part is they're hoping to get celebrities like James Franco, Ellen DeGeneres, Jennifer Lawrence, and Kanye West on board to donate tissue samples that will eventually become salamis. They describe a potential Ellen salami as black pepper and garlic with a playful kick of mustard for a highly approachable and well-rounded flavor. Jennifer Lawrence's as smoothed with notes of honey and spice with orange-zested ginger. Kanye's as best paired with strong straight bourbon. James Franco's salami would be arrogant, distinctive, and completely undeniable. How romantic! Here's another interesting fact. If eating meat made from human cell tissue sounds like cannibalism to you, you're not alone. When artist Orkin Telhan displayed Ouroboros steaks grown from human cells at the Design Museum in London, he received a flood of angry emails and social media posts labeling him wicked and pure evil. But Telhan's project was not intended to encourage us to eat each other. It's a statement about how we choose to use our own cells to produce lab-grown meats, but animals cannot do the same. Bite Labs told the Los Angeles Times that its primary goal is to provoke discussion and debate around topics of bioethics and celebrity culture. But they also stated unequivocally that they are gauging market interest for a lab-grown celebrity salami project. In the world's food production and distribution, we see inefficiencies, environmental hazards, and ethical issues. There are potential opportunities to revolutionize these industries while also opening up new avenues for celebrity culture consumption. To be clear, none of the celebrities featured in Bite Labs' promotional materials are actually associated with the project, but the company hopes that by tweeting at them, the public will get them and others on board. The primary science behind the process is called cultured meat. Wondering what it is? Cultured meat is a meat made from animal cells cultured in vitro. It is a type of cellular agriculture, and such agricultural methods are being investigated in light of increased consumer demand for protein. Tissue engineering techniques used in regenerative medicine are used to create cultured meat. Genetic engineering techniques such as gene insertion, deletion, silencing, activation, or mutation are not required to produce cultured meat. Cultured meat production allows biological processes that would normally take place within an animal to take place without the animal. Because cultured meat is grown in a controlled artificial environment, some people believe it more closely resembles hydroponic vegetables than genetically modified vegetables. However, in vitro cultivation requires the use of culture media. It is in change of supplying the macromolecules, nutrients, and growth factors required for cell proliferation. One of the most difficult tasks in cellular agriculture is sourcing growth factors. Although cultured meat does not involve genetic engineering, researchers may still use such methods to enhance quality and sustainability. More study is being conducted in this area. One enhancement made possible by genetic modification is the addition of nutrients like healthy fatty acids or cultured meat. By adjusting the cultured medium's parameters, the same enhancement can be achieved without genetic alteration. It's crucial that customers accept the goods. As cultured meat is grown in a sterile environment, there is no need for antibiotics. Today, the widespread use of antibiotics in conventional agriculture is the main driver of antibiotic resistance in humans. A study looking at acceptance of cultured meat in China, India, and the USA found high levels of acceptance of clean meat in the three most populous countries worldwide. Even though cultured meat contains the same animal muscle fat and support cells as regular meat does, in addition to blood vessels, some customers may find the high-tech production process intolerable. Cultured meat has been called fracken meat or fake. At the moment, cultured meat is significantly more costly than conventional meat.
We know what you're thinking.
That's nasty.
Ugh, doesn't sound right.
I'm not really into like lab-made things.
Anyways, our culture has an unhealthy obsession with celebrities. Everywhere you look, there are gossip sites, paparazzis, and magazines entirely devoted to them. People doing impressions of them and, sigh, tweets directed at them. People adore them, they are despised. People despise those who love them and love those who despise them. It's a disaster. So, what's next? We might start eating them now. And that concludes today's video. Did you like the video? If yes, then make sure you subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so that you can have a list of awesome videos to watch, and leave this video a like if you enjoyed it. We'll catch you with the next one, and until then, see you soon.